I'm at an age where I don't argue. I just leave. That's my new move. Ah, you argue with yourself. I'll be back. I'll be back. Hopefully when I come back, you don't got no energy. That's my fucking move. We was arguing in the morning. I left. It was 7 a.m. She called me. I'm in the car. She was like, you probably getting your dick sucked. At 7 a.m.? What bitch is that ambitious that's out here at 7 a.m. sucking dick? What type of day walker do you think I'm dealing with? Jesus Christ. A 7 a.m. dick sucker on the loose that's got you worried? What are you fucking reading? What's the blog that told y'all to worry about the dick sucker at 7 a.m.?
Seen too many people get knocked out. That's why I don't like to fight, man. You ever see somebody get knocked out, man? Like, knocked out. I'm talking about in person. Like, you witness somebody get knocked the hell out. It changes your opinion on fighting, doesn't it? When you see somebody get knocked out, you don't want to fight no more. Like, damn, that shit looked like it hurt. I don't know if I want to. I saw somebody get knocked out. Me and my boy, we had a club, right? We having a good time. We partying. Getting money. Getting money. We having a good time, right? Out of nowhere, that's how we party, because we both small. I don't hang with tall people. It was just us, right? So, out of nowhere, he gets into an argument with this guy at the bar. The guy at the bar got mad, punched my boy in the face. Bow! As soon as he hit him, my friend fell asleep. Now, when he woke up, he got mad at me. He was like, Kev, how come you ain't get him? And I was like, you know what? That's some selfish shit, because I just saw what he was capable of. You know what I mean? Like, he made you go to sleep. I'm not tired. I'm wide awake. I took a nap. Why would I walk right into that ass whooping? That's stupid. If he hit me and I go to sleep, who gonna wake who up? You understand what I'm saying?
You know the real reason why I wouldn't want to help my lady if she got attacked by a mountain lion? I don't know if I want to be with the woman that survived a mountain lion attack. I don't know if I'm gonna feel the same way about you when you come out that attack. Like, what if he got you good? What if he bit your neck up? Or if he bit your shoulder off? You ain't got no shoulder no more? That's tough. That's tough. I can't be with no girl that don't have no shoulder. I can't. I'm sorry. You can call me an asshole all you want. I can't be with a girl that can't do this. If you can't do that, if you can't shoulder shrug, bitch, I can't be with you. You can't shoulder shrug, bitch? You know how many times you shoulder shrug in a day? You know how many times you showed us wrong? Look, you did it a little bit just now. A little bit. Look at you. A little bit. Ladies, let me tell you something. You don't know how important your shoulders are until you lose one of them. Life will change without both shoulders. I promise you that. I tell you what, you can kiss halter tops goodbye. That's over. Every shirt you put on gonna look like a goddamn toga outfit. All that shit coming across the chest. I don't want to be with the toga bitch. I don't want her. The girl to look like she won a pageant every day? You won every day? Oh, here come Michelle. Here come Miss America.
I love the fact that I can travel. I love the fact that I can take my kids places that I never dreamed or imagined I'd be able to. Every year around the holidays, I take my kids to Aspen. Now, I don't want you guys to think I take my kids to Aspen because we can ski, because we cannot. I just like the fact that we're the only black people there when we go. It looks great. It just looks good. Last time we went, I actually got into an accident on the bunny slopes. I'm trying to learn how to ski. Now, on the bunny slopes, they don't give you ski poles. They take your ski poles away. The reason why is because they want you to get comfortable with going from right to left and falling. So I'm on the bunny slopes. They push me down the slope. I'm in my ski stance, right? I'm going down. At the corner of my eye, I see a kid coming this way. Now, I'm not good at math. I'm not good at math at all. But I know if he keeps coming this way and I keep going this way, we're gonna fuck each other up somewhere up here. As I'm getting closer, I'm like, yo, I'm about to hit this kid. My instructors start yelling, fall, fall, fall. I'm trying, I can't. They didn't teach me, I'm not going down. Now I gotta make a decision. Do I just run this kid over and keep going? Or do I become a hero? I chose to do some hero shit. As I got closer, I picked the kid up. I said, bah. When I picked the kid up, I thought that the weight would make me stop. But instead, we did like a little hop, and we start going down another slope. But this was the real shit. This was not a part of the bunny slope. I knew it was real, because when we start going down, this lady, she was like, he got my baby! And I was like, that's not good. That is not good at all. I said, God, please don't let this baby be white. Don't let this be a white baby.
I make the decision to use the bathroom at the airport. I'm in the bathroom stall, right? Once again, people, you cannot make shit like this up. This is what it looks like, people. Not for real, this is a life-size photo. This is really what it looks like. This is how small I am on an actual toilet. I'm in the bathroom. It's 6:30 in the morning. I'm by myself. By myself. It's quiet. It's just like this. Quiet. This is what I hear out of nowhere. Yo, Kev Hart, how long you gonna be, man? I wanna get a picture with you when you come out. Immediately, I put my feet up. I did this right here. I said, if you can't see my feet, he'll go away. He said, come on, man, I saw your feet already. I know you in there. Just give me a time frame. How long are you gonna be? Give me like 15, 20 minutes, man. Come on, man, that's too long. My flight leaving like 10 minutes. Just pinch it. Pinch it all for me. What the fuck? What? No, man. Anybody pinching nothing, man. Just get out of here. Kev, don't do me like that. I'm your biggest fan, man. I support everything you do. What would you do if you was me? I wouldn't let me shit by myself, man. Just get out of here. He said, Kev, come on. You know what? This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get my picture real quick. I'm just gonna put my phone over the stall. I'm gonna snap a picture real quick. The fear that went through my body of looking up and seeing the camera flash. Oh my God, I was scared because I didn't put toilet paper on the toilet seat. I didn't have time. I didn't want that picture to get out because I didn't want my fan base to know that I'd be raw butting these toilet seats sometime.
He said, guys, we're gonna do three-minute rounds. Nobody's here to hurt anybody. Let's have a good time. Keep it loose. He yells out, take it easy on him. I assume he's talking to me. He's gotta be talking to me. I yell back, gotcha, coach. Put a confident laugh behind it. We get to our corners, the bell rings, ding, I come out. I just want him to see that I can fight. You can tell I can fucking fight by the way I hold my shoulders. Look how I'm moving, My feet are spaced apart. Look at my fucking foot moving. Look how I'm fucking moving, bitch. This ain't gonna be no cakewalk. Yeah. You see it. He flat-footed. Oh, he not even on the balls of his foot. I'ma whoop his ass. I'm getting more confidence as I move around. My coach says, Kevin, stop playing. Let your hands go. All right. Ask and you shall receive. I hope he got the Weather Channel, because this is about to be some lightning. When you throw a jab, you take a step. Take a step. Let the jab go at the same time. Turn it over. Whap, every time. Whap, whap. That's how you throw it. I take my step. I'm about to turn it over. I'm right here. Here it is. About to turn that bitch over. You better brace yourself. Here it come. Ooh, it's coming. Right here. I'm right here, but I'm about to get here. Here I am, but I'm about to fucking get right there. You better brace yourself. I'm right here. Before I did that, he hit me. I immediately lost my vision. Immediately. I went blind. Immediately. Couldn't see shit. Everything was fucking black. I read that you can get brain damage or you can die from a punch. I just lost my fucking vision. I don't have eyesight no more. I can't see. I panicked. I turned around. I've been known to do this move several times. I start punching backwards. I've talked about it in my past specials. I'm a backwards puncher when I panic. I fucking start punching. My trainer said, Kevin, throw the jab. Throw the jab. I said, for what? Liar. It ain't lightning unless he's a storm tracker, okay? Because this is fucking ridiculous. I'm blind. I can't see shit. Ah! I'm blind. Ring the bell. Ring the fucking bell. The bell rings. I can't even get to the corner. I gotta follow his voice to the corner. Ah! As I get to the corner, my trainer, he's like, what's wrong? I said, I'm blind, man. I can't fucking see. He just lift my headgear up. Apparently, when he hit me, he knocked my headgear over my eyes. It was black, so I was just looking at the back of it the whole time. He was like, why didn't you lift it up? And I said, because we never went over that in practice. True story. I wake up 5:30 in the morning. I walk in my hallway. My dog went to the bathroom in the hallway. I see it. I got a decision to make. Do I go get my dog, discipline my dog, and clean this up right now? Or do I get back in the bed and deal with it later when I wake up? It's 5:30. I chose to get back in the bed. I'll deal with it later when I wake up. 7:15, my wife wakes up. All I hear is, oh, my God, the dog went to the bathroom in the hallway. I sat up acting like I didn't know nothing. You got to be fucking kidding me. I said, you want me to get it? You want me to clean it up? She was like, no, I'm up now. I'll get it. I was like, exactly. Exactly. I knew you would get it. That's why I left it there. I exactly'd you. At that moment, I thought to myself, I said, God damn it, Kevin, is this the kind of man you want to be? Do you want to be the man that doesn't give 100% because you know your other half is going to put up the percentage that you failed to give? No, I don't. I don't. And I was about to be that guy until my best friend Harry showed up in my house with his 2-year-old baby. Harry's got a 2-year-old baby. I call his baby a great baby. Let me tell you guys what I mean when I say a great baby. A great baby is a baby that does adult shit at a baby age. Now, Harry showing up in my house with this baby unannounced was a bitch move. I didn't like that at all. That was a bitch move. But my wife fell for it. As soon as she saw the baby, she was like, oh, my God. Oh, my God. No. No. Y'all haven't had a break since y'all had that baby. Leave the baby with me and Kev. We gonna watch the baby for y'all today. He said, Kev, is that okay with you? I said, as you can see, I don't run my household. I have no control over my household.
I got a lot of animals out there, people. Coyotes, mountain lions, rattlesnakes. It's at the point now where I don't like taking out trash, being honest with you. Reason why I don't like taking out trash in my house is because to take out the trash, I gotta walk outside, I gotta walk down my driveway. Trash cans are at the end of my driveway. My driveway is long as shit, people, okay? It also gets real dark in my driveway. Reason why I get so dark in my driveway at nighttime is because I turned down the option to get lights going down the side of my driveway. Reason why I turned down the option is because I thought the contractors were trying to take advantage of me because they knew that I had money. I don't trust people that do this when they talk. Like, that's how he was talking to me. He was like, hey, man, you gotta get some lights. Get real dark out here. You gotta get some lights. I don't need no fucking lights. It's a driveway. You drive in, you drive out. What the fuck I need lights for? I was wrong, people. I need lights. Can't see shit in this goddamn driveway. You gotta understand, I don't like being in the dark hearing animal noises, especially when I can't see the animal. It fucks with me. When you by yourself and you get scared, you do stupid shit. When you hear this, you do stupid shit when you get scared. You bite me, I'll bite you back, bitch. You start doing shit you saw in the movies. What are you waiting for?
I don't like dolphins. I'm scared of dolphins. I am. Me and my wife, we was in Maui, right? We in Maui. She's like, come on, babe. We should go swim with the dolphins. I was like, nah. I told you how I feel about them dolphins. She's like, come on, stop being a bitch. Let's just do it. I was like, don't call me no bitch. She's like, bitch? Man, whatever. Like, you know, we don't got to come back, so you just got to, you stupid. That's all I had. I didn't have nothing else to say. So we go, we get there. They got the dolphins in this tank. It's like 8 dolphins in this tank, right? When I get there, I see this old lady on the back of a dolphin. I see this little boy. I'm like, you know what, babe? I might have been overreacting. Get the camera, take some pictures of me on the back of the dolphin. I was hyped, right? I get in the water. I'm on the back of the dolphin. The instructor, he was like, as soon as you grab the dolphin fin, the dolphin's gonna start taking you around. So whenever you're ready, grab his fin. I was like, all right, cool. I'm ready. As soon as I grabbed my dolphin fin, my dolphin went straight to the bottom of the tank. Like, he just went down. So because I was scared, I didn't let go. I held on. Like, you know when you're scared, how you start to mentally create shit in your own mind? I was like, okay, it's obvious that I got a racist dolphin. He don't like black people. He done cut a deal with a shark, bring him a black piece of meat. Something bad about to happen, right? So I let go. I get to the top. When I let go, I'm so scared, I start snapping on the instructor as soon as I see him. I was like, nobody saw fucking dolphin number 8 missing? Huh? Y'all didn't notice I was going for like 30 seconds? He tried to kill me! I was mad, yo. I was so fucking scared. I was like, y'all see the old lady and a little boy, but nobody saw the black fucking swirl missing? Huh? Nobody noticed that the black dot wasn't going around. Y'all didn't notice that? He's like, calm down, man. Calm down. It's 3 feet. Just stand up. I was like, what? What'd he say? I didn't even realize that I was walking and talking shit at the same time. Come to find out, I never even went underwater. What happened was some water splashed in my face. And I panicked. Ah! 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 I made it up. I made it all up. I was scared. I never lied that fast in my life. He was racist, though. I know he was racist. You know, I know he was racist, because when I got out the water, you know how dolphins like, gig it, gig it. They be doing that, like, gig it, gig it. Well, he looked at me. He's like, nigga, nigga, nigga. And I was like, what? Blew my whistle in his face. I don't play that shit. He don't work there. I got him fired.